of enduring musical genius, filled with love and affection for anyone he meets. David Helfgott is one of a kind, and it was his life that inspired the biographical drama Shine. It's been 20 years since Geoffrey Rush played Helfgott, winning an Academy Award for his performance. Our reporter Craig Bennett caught up with the musical prodigy and his wife and full-time carer, Gillian.
He was the man who inspired the award-winning film, Shine.
Oh, is that your piano, Sylvia? Sylvia.
Oh, this is so beautiful, Toby. Not Toby, Tony, Tony, not Tony. You're beautiful too, Tony. Oh.
Concert pianist David Helfgott was stunningly portrayed by Academy Award winner Geoffrey Rush, from his challenging childhood through to his harrowing mental breakdown. David became known as a child prodigy after his Polish-born father started teaching him piano at the tender age of five. For the past 32 years, he's been happily married to his second wife, Gillian. They live on a serene property in the Promised Land in northern New South Wales. I visited their gorgeous home and caught up with the incredible musician and his doting wife.
Gillian!
Joy to see you again. I in the promised land here. Wow.
It's aptly named, isn't it?
Oh, you betcha, Bippy, it is. Hello, David. What a joy to see you. Thank you very much.
We've had an amazing 32 years relationship. He's taught me a huge amount. He's grown. My children adore him and have been a huge support to me and friends. I really haven't had one boring day in 32 years. And how many people can say that? I've had many tiring days, and of course, I'm a lot older than he is.
Because David is a constant hugger. He's a cyclone of energy.
Yes.
Loves everything about life and everyone in life.
Yes, he does. He's extraordinary. There's no malice in him. He's kind to everything. Any beetle that comes in here, he lifts it out so carefully and puts it in the garden.
I don't know how they managed to move these.
How did they get them here?
I have no idea.
Oh, come on, David.
Simon planned that.
Gillian and David met one day in Perth and fell instantly in love.
He said, I'm going to come around for a swim tomorrow again. So he arrived the next morning, and I walked out to the pool with him, and in a very quiet voice, not like the gabble, he looked at me and he said, Gillian, would you marry me?
How did you respond to that?
I nearly said yes.
What stopped you from saying yes?
A little bit of common sense at that stage. I hadn't spent many hours with him before we agreed to be together. I knew once I agreed, that was for life. This wasn't a relationship you go in and treat lightly.
Will you marry me?
Wouldn't be very practical, David.
Gillian realised the seriousness of his condition. After his first marriage had broken down, David spiralled into a deep depression that saw him institutionalised and barred from doing the one thing he loved, playing music. He was forced to undergo 10 years of intense psychiatric treatment.
That period was such a lack of knowledge.
Well, he endured electroshock therapy, didn't he?
Well, I can't for sure say this. That part of the records about that don't seem to exist. But he certainly had a lot of very strong medical therapy.
For those who don't know, David deals with schizoaffective disorder. What exactly, Gillian, is that?
Nobody knows. He's just had another assessment. The top psychiatrist cannot find a pocket to put him in. The latest assessment is we can't put a label on him. He has a little bit of Asperger's and a little bit of Tourette or something like that, but he doesn't have any one thing.
It is Geoffrey Rush's impeccable portrayal of Helfgott that Gillian is eternally thankful for.
He captured David's quirky personality and his repetition of speech and this sort of thing, because he's a consummate actor. In fact, it was rather hilarious. At one scene of the shooting, Geoffrey went running past, and we'd left David back at the hotel, and I started to run after Geoffrey, thinking it was David who got there. And I really felt I had two husbands for a while. It was so strange.
Although Geoffrey Rush was director Scott Hicks's first choice, there was pressure on another Hollywood actor to play the role.
He'd tried for 10 years to get it financed, no luck. And he was in Hollywood, and this famous producer offered him sort of unlimited money as long as he didn't have Geoffrey Rush in the lead. He wanted to put a famous Hollywood actor in. And Scott walked away from that.
And the Oscar goes to Geoffrey Rush and Shine.
Geoffrey was perfect for the role. And that's why when Geoffrey held up the statue, sort of indicating for those of you who didn't have faith in me, here I've won the Academy Award for the performance, and rightly so.
And to the unstoppable David Helfgott, the front of my script said that this story was inspired by the events of your life. You truly are an inspiration. When are you gonna
come down? I think it was after the Academy Awards we went to Elton John's birthday party.
Did you pinch yourself thinking, yes, I'm Elton John's birthday party?
Yeah, there's a beautiful photograph we have of Elton John and David. He was an incredibly friendly, charming man.
No matter how many stars David and Gillian rub shoulders with, they still remain humble.
You've also found out, though, that David is a wonderful housekeeper. Everything is spotless.
It's marvellous. He was the biggest grub. You know, in the bathroom, leave 5 towels, and of course, well, he's flooded the bath a few times here. And it comes down through this air conditioning onto the rug. That's why we built a bath on the veranda, so if he floods it, it'll only go into the garden. But on the whole, he was incredibly untidy. And now he pegs out the washing, brings it in, folds it up and puts it away. He makes the bed, and when I wasn't well for a while, he made the bed while I was in it. And that was interesting, having a sheet tugged straight across you. I said, David, I need to breathe. But he makes that of it. He runs the bath for me and calls me up. Now, how many husbands do that?
And every evening he says goodnight to the sunset?
Yes, he does. Darling, come and see the sunset. And even if it's not much of a sunset.
And it's when you sit next to David at the piano, you see his true love and genius shine through.
Musical genius of David, but his wife Gillian, she is extraordinary, beautiful. Isn't she? Yeah.
But what a love story.
Yeah. That's a great love story.
You think devotion, what devotion to one another, and it's fantastic.
And then the practicality of building a bath outside if it floods. Yeah. That's what impressed me.
That's love, but that's love as well, isn't it?